Cindy Smith, and as a lot of TV people know, Suellen and I started, there are several of us in the group, started with GE back in June of 1981. And Suellen and I became best friends right away. The next year, I think, in 82, Suellen and Ken were getting divorced, and Suellen said, "You've got to move in with me. You've got to move in with me." And I was living downtown in Bedbury Courtney. I was only paying $150 a month for my rent, and it was going to be about that much for me to move in with her. And I said, "Well, you're going to have to find somebody else to move in with this, because I'll make it cheaper. You know, I'm going to give my time." So anyway, she found Joe Neeters, who also worked with us. So it was Suellen and I, and Joe Neeters moved into the house, and we lived there for, I think Joe lived with us for a couple of years, and then we had two more girls move in. So I think our rent got down to about $82 a month. Utilities and everything, which was wonderful. But we had, oh my God, we had such a great time. And we had this wonderful trip to California where it was Suellen, Annie, me, and Melanie Euler. I don't know, a lot of people know Melanie. And Annie had a Volkswagen van camper, and she was a teacher, and she picked us up in Las Vegas. And we started in Las Vegas, and 14 days later, we flew out of San Francisco, and we saw everything in between, and we just had a fabulous time. But, Suellen has been part of my family. We went to New York together. We worked together. GE Plastics asked us to go to New York, and so we lived up there for a while, and then came back, and Suellen continued working for Plastics, and I went back working for GE, but we've stayed close over the years. And she was part of my family. My whole family was here earlier because she came to all of our family functions just like everybody else. And after she passed away, I said, it's amazing that everybody she knew thought she was their best friend. I mean, for a cup of crap the whole time. I'm sorry. But anyway, let's get to a funny story. After Suellen retired, you know, she came back to work for GE, and she was actually sitting in the cubicle away from me, so I could hear her talk all the time. And every time I hear my name, I go running over there because I was afraid she'd be telling a story. I was like, "I'm still working here. You're retired." But there's one time we had a Christmas dinner, and if you all don't know, we have a place at GE called Monogram Hall, which is a big hall, and you can go in there for auditorium meetings, and there's meeting rooms. And then they built, a few years later, they built a place called the Monogram Experience Center. And Monogram Experience Center is this really, really, really nice place where they bring customers in that buy Monogram products, and they teach them how to cook. But they hired the chef Joe Castro, who used to be the chef at the Brown. And so it's wonderful if you get to go over there, if you get to experience. So our office was going over there, and I said, "Suellen, I'll save you a spot, you know, when I get over there." So we had this wonderful meal, and she never, you know, I had this chair open next to me the whole time. She never showed up, and I'm like, "Where is she? Where is she?" So I came back, and she was at her desk, and I said, "Where were you?" "Well, I was there." I said, "No, you were." And she said, "Yes, I was." Well, she had taken a co-op. They had gone to Monogram Hall. And there was another group having like a potluck. She didn't know anybody in there. They kept asking, "Well, where are you from?" So they ate, and then they made plates to take back to the people that were on the host team that couldn't go. So anyway, that was
That's great.